As a group of violent protesters stormed the U.S. Capitol building on Wednesday, encouraged by President Donald Trump's claim of a stolen election, congressional leaders were locked down in an undisclosed location and temporarily had to stop their joint session to certify President-elect Joe Biden's win. As they tried to stay safe amid the chaos, Trump's staunch supporters in Congress tweeted for the riot to end. House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy called the event unacceptable and un-American. Florida Congressman Matt Gaetz stressed that America does not accept political violence. Those sentiments were felt by some Fil-Am Republican leaders. Christina Osmeña, who lost her bid for California's 14th congressional district in 2018, wrote in a Facebook post that the event at the Capitol was a disgrace and that the election is over. Also in a Facebook post, Jeff Coleman, who served as state congressman for Pennsylvania, wrote, "A leader's words and actions had devastating consequences. Those of us who hold this conviction have a responsibility to write a better story for our children. America's story cannot end this way." For his part, Utah's Attorney General Sean Reyes tweeted that he condemns in the strongest terms the acts of violence at the Capitol building. Meanwhile, Ron Falcone, Mayor of Brunswick, Ohio, and the Asian American Pacific Islander advisor for the Trump administration expressed his disgust for the riot at the Capitol.
"It should be condemned. It certainly doesn't speak for me or any member of the Republican Party."
Falcone compares the protesters at the Capitol to Black Lives Matter demonstrators.
"Once you resort to violence, and once you resort to attacks on the police, that's almost unheard of for anyone who claiming to be a Republican. This is something, you know, that left-wing groups did last year and during the summer."
Despite Trump calling for people to gather on January 6th to rally against what he calls a stolen election, Falcone believes the president is not accountable for the violent incident.
The small group of people that did this, that stormed the Capitol, I think those people should be prosecuted and prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law. And I hope that they're jailed, you know, period. The president did not tell anyone to destroy and to vandalize the Capitol."
While Falcone did not confirm if he accepts the results of the 2020 presidential elections, he did point out that there were many so-called irregularities that should be investigated. Rommel Conclara, ABS-CBN News.